I did pretty good for myself. Rome was ruled too long by the Republic. They needed someone like me to get things done.
I know I'd die this way. In my business, we all do.
I conquered so many territories for Rome, defeated all those who opposed me. I turned Rome into an even bigger empire, and while doing so, made myself quite a powerful figure.
I suppose it was time for a new godfather. I had a good run though. Took over many competing games and made a lot of money.
I remember the day I came back from Rome after defeating Pompey. The crowds were cheering for me. Decorations in the street, everyone praising the name Caesar.
I remember well coming home from the slaughter of Virgil Saluzzo and his rotten family. He tried to kill me 2 times.
Then Flavius and Aurelius start calming down the crowd, start taking down the decorations, saying, I'm trying to be dictator? I got even with them. Took them out of the Senate.
I don't understand why the families are so upset. Virgil's dead. No big deal. The other families thought I was trying to take over. Well, maybe I was. They should not have tried to mess with me.
Ah, I remember walking through the gardens with my wife, Calpurnia, and my dear friend Mark Antony. Oh, and the crowds. They treated me like I was a god.
I told them what to do and when to do. Sure, Virgil was once my right-hand man. But he tried to kill me. 2 times! I have my wife Carmelo and Tom Hagen, my consigliere. I can trust them. I can trust them.
That Mark Antony, my best friend, my right-hand man, he was too close to ever turn against me. Too happy, too loyal.
Tom's a good kid. Smart. He's got my back.
Yeah, Mark Antony, a great friend. Unlike Cassius, he was always brooding and planning. I always suspected he was up to something not good.
Don't get me started on Fredo.
That deceitful Cassius, turning my friends against me, telling Brutus lies that Brutus should be in power. Cassius knew that he could not defeat me without turning Brutus against me. So Brutus fell for the lies of Cassius and agreed to help in this disgraceful act against both me and Rome.
There were signs. There were signs. Fredo and Tom thought I wasn't paying attention. But I was.
There were a lot of signs. Maybe I was just too caught up in my own ego to see them. I can tell you this. When a stranger tells you to be aware of a day in March, maybe you should listen.
I saw them meeting in the rain. They were hiding under umbrellas. I remember that rain. It wouldn't stop.
Those lightning storms and the thunder. And lions roaming around where they shouldn't be.
My wife, Carmelo, she seemed to know something. But she said nothing. Nothing!
What was maybe the most obvious sign was Brutus. He looked like he was worried, like he had to tell me something. Now I know.
My son, Sonny, tells me about dreams he had. Foolish nonsense. Who doesn't dream about massacred bodies?
My wife, Calpurnia, tried to warn me. She told me of her visions, of blood pouring from my body. I ignored her on the advice of my so-called friends, who told me I would look weak if I stayed in.
I should have read Sonny's letter. Fredo's nervous. Fredo tells me his business with Tom. What business? Fredo's an idiot!
I should have listened to my wife.
Nah, it was fate. My death, it was fate.
All those warnings, and I failed to heed them. It was out of my control. The gods had other plans for me.
So, I got to be a big shot. You live, you die. Did I piss a few people off? Sure. We all die.
Why would they want me dead? I was their great leader. Their greatest leader.
I still remember hearing the machine guns blaring. So many guns. And Tom, my trusted Tom, delivering the final shot.
So many knives coming from every direction, but the one that stung the most was the last one, from Brutus.
Lots of women crying. That was nice.
Excuses. Look at them at my funeral. Brutus claiming he did this for the good of Rome? That I was too ambitious? That I wanted to be king? This is preposterous.
What's this? Tom Hagen hugging my wife? Disrespecting me after my death?
At least Mark Antony's on my side, telling them of the good I did for Rome, how I turned down the crown, showing them my blood-stained cloak. That's right, show these people what those traitors did to me. Ah, look, the crowd has turned against my conspirators. At least the people of Rome still know what's right. Run, Brutus. Run, Cassius. You shall soon be with me.
Wait, there's Fredo, hiding behind a tree. What's he holding? Oh boy, this is about to be fun. Fredo, you idiot! Sure, you'll get a few shots off, but they're all carrying. You'll all be dead.
Hello, Brutus. It's me, Caesar. And I'm in your dreams. Good luck at your fight in Fallopian tomorrow.
Well, that looks like a bloody mess. Carmelo, dead. Fredo, never had a chance. What's this? Tom, shooting himself? Well, I guess he couldn't wait for Sonny to finish him off.
So, Cassius, can't bear to think he sent his friend Titanius to his death? Has to kill himself? I shall see you soon, Cassius.
Like I said, we all die in the end.
Oh, poor Brutus. Can't bear to be a loser. Wait, what's Strato doing? Wait, what's Brutus doing? Ah, died like a Roman general should.
My funeral? It wasn't bad.
I died too soon. But so did they. But Rome still lives on.